bloody will!
Come on, mate. We're off to a bad start. It's 100 leagues or more to Havana. Will you walk that distance?
Posh git. Where's he running to?
Follow and I'll tell you.
We could work together on this.
Keep your distance!
Imbecile!
Señor Duncan Walpole, I accept your most generous offer and await your arrival with eagerness.
That schooner'll do me just fine.
Kingston, where to commandeer this lover's ship and follow.
Kingston? No, our destination is Havana. I'm just a merchant.
Quiet, you bleeding pirate! You'll hang for the mess you made out there!
I had nothing to do with this attack. My crew and I... By God's grace, sir, you saved me. Lacking a rowboat, I'm afraid we'll have to swim to my ship.
Hardly the worst thing to happen.
Oh, this is difficult. I should have taken the coat off.
Welcome aboard, Duncan. She's a modest schooner, but well suited to my purpose, trafficking cargo from my plantation and such.
She'll do fine. There's a strong wind now. Let's strike to full, shall we?
Ah, there's a tug of the wind at my hair. Ah, I find a bracing comfort in the feel and smell of the ocean. The raw stink of possibility.
That's a top way of seeing it, mate.
We've really opened it up now, haven't we?
Those sailors were quite animated by the idea of pirates roaming these waters. Is it a real danger, do you suppose?
A possibility. But most pirates stalk the windward passage between Cuba and Hispaniola.
Oh, I see. Yes. That is a bustling strait.
But I shouldn't worry about being waylaid by pirates, truth be told. My ship is small, and I have nothing of immense value. Sugarcane in its yields, molasses, rum, that sort of thing.
There's not a pirate living who'd turn his back on a keg of rum.
Well, yes. Yes, I suppose that's true.
Trim us off the wing!